children. Welcome back to e-class of social science. Today I will be explaining part 2 of first chapter. We had done that the famous king Harshavardhan, who was ruling in North India, that is the state of Kannauj, how he ruled and what was, whom did he conquer, his sister was imprisoned, he fled from the clutches of the king of God, and after freeing his sister from the clutches of the king of God, how he ruled over his kingdom. Let us see. His rule is said to be the golden rule of North India. Let us continue. Immediately after ascending the throne, he decided to free his imprisoned sister Rajeshwari. In the meanwhile, she had escaped from the clutches of Devagupta and ran away into the Vindhya forest, went in search for his sister, and with the help of the people living in the forest and a Buddhist hermit, Dwikarmitra, he stopped her from committing sati. So, Rajeshwari was about to commit sati. And at that same time, he reached there. Since Rajeshwari's kingdom, Kannauj, was without a king at that time, Harshavardhan became its ruler. So, Harshavardhan became the ruler. Later, he defeated Devagupta, the king of Malwa. So, the king, Devagupta, was the king of Malwa. He had imprisoned his sister. Okay. As a part of his preparation to launch an attack on Sashank, the god king, he formed an alliance with the king of Kamrup, Bhaskara Varman. With the help of a large army, he defeated the god king and won over a major part of his kingdom. So he was victorious. He also conquered Malwa and Saurashtra, but was unsuccessful in defeating Pulakeshi too. Yes, children, here it is very important to note that Pulakeshi too also was a very powerful ruler of South India. Just as King Harshavardhan was a powerful ruler of North India, in the same way, Pulakeshi too was the ruler of South India, a very powerful ruler of South India. He was of the Chalukya dynasty and ruled over South India. After 7 successive victorious years, Thaneshwar emerged as a large kingdom in North India. So, you know what is Thaneshwar? Thaneshwar is the present Punjab and Haryana. So, after 7 successive victorious years, he then Thaneshwar emerged as the last kingdom in North India. Let us see how was Harshavardhan's reign and administration. Yes, children, kings, those who are very successful, their rule is considered to be the golden rule. Their subjects are living peacefully in the kingdom. There is the development of art and literature, architecture, and all other cultures are preserved in their kingdom. So, this is history is all about their success stories. So, let us see how was his reign and his administration. Harshavardhan personally supervised the administration of his state by traveling extensively, very far away into the interior lands, to different parts of his empire. He divided his daily routine into 3 parts. The first was for administrative purposes, while the other 2 parts were devoted to public welfare and religious activities. As he was very powerful, he was also very religious minded. Children, do remember, King Harshavardhan was very religious minded. He was diligent, he was intelligent in carrying out his administrative responsibilities, that at times he even forgot to have his meal. So, children, he was so busy in the activities of his kingdom, he was so engrossed that he did not even eat his meals. sometimes. So you can see the handwriting, the beautiful handwriting of King Harshavardhan here in your textbook. Yes, children. We continue with the other things in his administration that is important to know. To help him in the administration, Harshavardhan had commander-in-chief of the army, the Pratihara, that was known as the Dwarpal, Sandhi Vigraha, the foreign minister, Rajputa, the ambassador, Parvajya Mantri, Mahabandhanika, that is the chief justice, and the Akshar Patlika, that is the registrar of the universities. Okay, so these were the people who were helping him in his administration. So, imprints left by Harshavardhan. We come to the next point. Harsha built many rest houses where people who used to travel can rest. Wells, step wells, lakes, matthas and viharas, and also prohibited animal slaughter, the cutting of the animals. Many people in those days used to eat the meat of many animals. So he prohibited. They were penalized if they cut those animals. Every year he organized a Buddhist religious meet, and every 5 years he would organize religious congregation at Praya. There he would donate generously till his entire treasury was empty, and would even give away the ornaments he would be wearing at that time. So he used to give away the ornaments also to the people. Continuing with this, the great Sanskrit poet and writer Bhanavat adorned his court. So his court adorned many famous scholars, many famous writers. His famous works like Harshacharitra and the Kadambari are famous even today. We come to know about many important aspects of King Harshavardhan's reign from Harshacharitra. King Harsha himself was a writer and wrote 3 plays, Naganatha, Ratnavali and the Priyadarshika. So these were the 3 famous plays which were written by King Harsha. So he was also interested in literature. You can see the map of India where the Chalukyas ruled, where the city of Kannauj is in North India, and the Pallavas ruled. This was the empire which was ruled by Pulakeshi II, the area which is colored in yellow, and the area which is colored in pink is the rule of King Harsha. Okay, children, let us proceed further and see how Emperor Harshavardhan loved to establish the university, his love for education. He established the Nalanda University, a very famous university in those days. King Harsha extended all possible assistance to Acharya Shilabhadra and made Nalanda into a world famous university. The university had access to the revenues of 100 villages given to them by King Harsha for its upkeep and maintenance. So King Harsha allowed the Acharya Shilabhadra to take the money of the revenue of the 100 villages, and that money which was collected as revenue from the villages used to give away for the maintenance of this Nalanda University. Renowned chemist Acharya Nagarjuna, who proved that iron, arsenic and mercury ash could be used as also medicine. So these were the famous researches done in those days, children. Do remember that iron, arsenic and mercury ash could also be used in medicine. Also belong to Nalanda University. Yes, students, things to know. Students had to clear an entrance test for admission into Nalanda University. It was not very easy to enter this university. Free education, lodging and boarding provided in Nalanda University. The extensive library of Nalanda University was known children, with this we come to the end of the second part of our first chapter. Children, do read the textbook. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.